Hello guys, this is Eric TCH. In this video, I'm going to show you how I modify my repeat rate.
We'll be right back.
is a repeater that I've done. I've integrated the priming slide and the handle from the disruptors. For the priming slide, it holds my DIY stock much better, and for the handles, it gives me a much more comfortable feel as the original stock is kind of small for an adult hands. For the rest of the disruptor, I'm going to attach them to my folding cozy spring dome shop. I've also used two different types of epoxy putty in this project. For most of the plastic to plastic part, I'm using a plumbing epoxy putty. But for the stock, it is made by rubber, so I figured out that the normal epoxy putty doesn't work well on it because it flex. So what I do, I get a piece of wood, I nail on it, then I stick them together using a wood epoxy putty. It is more stable right now, and the pipe that I use is kind of different. It is semi-transparent, as you can see, the lights can go through it. The description here, it is called a UPC pipe. It flex a lot and not as hard as a PVC pipe. I like the characteristic of this pipe. This makes it super flexible when moving around my hand. This part of the stock, it is made by a rubber vacuum stick from a vacuum cleaner. The vacuum stick, I trimmed it from Goodwill. Also planning to add a switch here and cover the network batteries once I get the materials. I'll be using this plaster mainly for HVZ and CQD style game. It is using a Michel 2.0 motor from foam blast and 950 batteries. It is small enough to fit into a rapid rate battery tray. I don't recommend this battery if you are using it on a Strive with any 2S motor, as there's a lot of higher amperage and better battery choice like this one, what I use on my Strive, and I believe most of the people does. This upgrade is good enough for its own purpose now. I tried in 2 Nerf 4 like 2 weeks ago. Great, I'm not planning to spend any extra money on the flywheel and cage due to my tight budget. That's all, thanks for watching and I hope you enjoyed it. Do like this video and subscribe my YouTube channel, as in the future I'm going to share more about my project in this YouTube channel.